Let's get you some big news now. India's moon mission has reached a step closer to history as Chandrayaan 2 entered the lunar orbit this morning. India's second lunar mission entered the orbit of the Earth's natural satellite at 9:02 a.m. Chandrayaan is due to land on the moon's south pole in September. Let me go across to my colleague Pramod Madhav, who is joining us live with further updates on this. Pramod, it's a big day, a huge milestone that has been achieved. Of course, ISRO inching a step closer to creating history. But can you tell us the significance of this and the fact that it looks like the entire mission is on track to do a soft landing on the south pole of the moon on September 7th?
Well, it certainly is extremely significant because the amount of money that's been spent over here and the achievement ISRO has pulled out, that's the one that actually creates a ratio. Because imagine from India, a team is able to actually launch. Already we have gone all the way to Mars, but this time we have to gone ahead and decided to land on the moon, a soft landing with a rover for 14 days. It will do research. No longer this is a technology demonstration. This is very serious. ISRO is actually competing with all other giants to create a kind of an outpost in the moon itself. Deep space research is the next mission. You can go ahead for asteroid mining or a lot of other things, but you need a kind of a separate, a kind of a proper strong base in the moon. Yes, we have International Space Station and various other stuff, but this one is extremely important because we are going to, if we are able to actually achieve what we have planned, which means there are vast steps that can go ahead, and the competition right now is definitely between us and Blue Ocean and SpaceX, and we are almost there. Just four steps and we will do a soft landing, and from then on there on a new chapter in ISRO's page will begin.
Absolutely. In fact, we had spoken to a couple of analysts also in this, and they've all raised one of the big concern of how the success rate of landing on the moon, the soft landing on the moon, has been less. But of course, with the fleet and the achievement that ISRO has put forward, the kind of milestone it's putting in place is definitely giving in a lot of optimism and confidence to the people that yes, we are going to be the next nation to make us remarkable around the world.
Well, that's true, because the way the planning has been done and the enormous amount of effort that's been put on. In fact, various information about the planning is not yet being revealed as well, because we predict after samples being removed, taken back from the moon, that the moon's surface is made of a compound called as anorthosite, and the same sort of compound was available in Tamil Nadu. This information is not actually on the open source, but through sources we come to know that a large amount of that kind of compound was removed. Mined from Tamil Nadu and taken to ISRO research centers, where already creating the same kind of situation when the rover has to land on the surface of the moon. Those things were already done. Simulations were done about soft landing. And the bigger worrisome part here is that recently Israel was not able to do that, but China did it. And the thing is that you do not have a kind of a space over air resistance at this spot, which means you cannot do a landing with a parachute or any other kind. But the moon's gravity is much lesser than that of Earth, which means the weight of the lunar will actually decrease. So keeping all those in mind and the way they have trained, it definitely is going to be a positive result.
Absolutely. We're going to be waiting for all those updates. In fact, we're also given to understand the ISRO chairperson will be also briefing the media in a short while later today to tell us about the details of what has happened today and the significance of the lunar orbit insertion of Chandrayaan 2. For the moment, Pramod, many thanks for joining us with all those updates. Shifting focus to other news now, the civic body Mumbai has passed a proposal of giving a 15% rebate on the property tax to the housing societies that segregate and process waste of their premises. The move will apply to the housing societies who will have to follow three procedures. First, the society will get a 5% rebate for segregating and composting the waste, and another 5% for recycling dry waste, and a further 5% for using rainwater or recycled grey water. The housing society following just one process will get only a 5% rebate, while those meeting all the three processes will get a full 15% rebate.
15% rebate on property tax to housing societies here in the city of Mumbai. That is the proposal now which has been cleared by the BMC after long many years. What we understand is the fact that this property tax rebate will be given to housing societies that segregate wet waste on premises, dispose of the dry waste using recyclers, and lastly, rainwater harvesting. In fact, many housing societies have already started doing this, and we are here in one such housing society in Kandivali in the city of Mumbai, where at least two processes of segregating wet waste on premises as well as rainwater harvesting is already being done. As you can see, my video journalist Sahil is showing you that this is how the process is being carried out. The society here in concern generates more than 125 to 150 kg of waste every single day.
This has done tremendously good for our society because we are saving on the manure. Because you will see that all we are generating around 150 kg of wet waste, and which is segregated from all the dry waste, and then it has been put for decomposing. This is a shredder. We have two shredders, and this is one of the shredder. The wet waste is shredded and then it is put in the drums.
I think environment, being environment conscious, is the need of the art, and that's what, because we said there are so many flats in the society. If each one of us does our part well, I think it's going to really help the environment, especially in a place like Bombay where the generation of waste is huge and our wastelands are dying out. So that was the idea behind it.
While the BMC has come up with these incentives to encourage waste management, it has also imposed some very strict penalties. Those housing societies which generate more than 100 kilograms of waste and do not follow the waste management procedure, their power and water supply would be disconnected. They would also be fined 10,000 rupees along with a 3-year jail term for the society's committee members.
To keep a check on the housing society, there will be surprise inspections which will be conducted by the BMC, and if at all, if there is any violation that takes place inside the housing society, then they can be even fined or penalized up to 10,000 rupees. With video journalist Sahil, this is Isha Shah reporting here from Mumbai for Mirror Now.
And time now to take a quick look at what else is making headlines across the nation. Home Minister Amit Shah met National Security Advisor Ajit Doval and the Chief of the Intelligence Bureau to discuss the situation in Jammu and Kashmir, where restrictions are being lifted in phases. The huge security blanket was put in place for more than 2 weeks ago, ahead of the government's announcement about the removal of the state's special status.
Good morning, all my friends from media. First of all, let me apologize for a small delay that due to the operational reasons for this press meet. I would say today the Chandrayaan 2 mission crossed a major milestone. And the precise lunar orbit insertion maneuver carried out at 9 o'clock for about 30 minutes precisely injected the Chandrayaan 2 in a defined orbit in a perfect way. As we are aware, in order to achieve the moon orbit with the inclination of 90 degrees. This is a unique requirement only Chandrayaan has, which no other moon mission has. That is, this particular requirement of 90 degrees is achieved by the precise execution of TLI and LOI maneuvers. And now the Chandrayaan 2 is going around the moon in an orbit of 114 kilometer perihelion and 18,000 kilometer apogee with the inclination of 88 degrees. In a due course, this orbit will be brought down near to 100 by 100 and then further by 100 by 30. And at that time, the inclination of the orbit also will achieve 90 degrees, so that we will achieve the mission of the power descent. Friends, subsequent to the launch of Chandrayaan 2 on July 22nd, the earthbound maneuvers happened on Chandrayaan 2 to raise its orbit to the altitude of something like 141,000 kilometers. Then on 14th August 2:21 AM, the very important maneuver, the translunar injection, it's happened, by which the Chandrayaan 2 was injected towards moon with a velocity of 10.9 km per second, which sends the Chandrayaan 2 to an apogee altitude of 418,000 km, which is 7,000 km above the moon orbit. And at the apogee point, the velocity of the vehicle or Chandrayaan 2 is something like 0.1 km per second. In order to show or tell you the importance of the translunar injection accuracy or precision, just I want to tell, out of 10.9 km per second, in case there is a dispersion of 10 cm per second velocity difference, that will end up with the orbital inclination of the at the moon will be away by 7 degrees. We will not able to meet the requirement of meeting the soft landing at the South Pole. This is the type of accuracy we are talking. And once this the Chandrayaan 2 travels towards the apogee point, then when it is the return back from the apogee point, yesterday, 19th, around 3 p.m., the moon also gone near to the Chandrayaan 2. Then Chandrayaan 2 was entered into the sphere of influence of moon. And from that time onwards, the Chandrayaan 2 was under the influence of the gravity of the moon, and Chandrayaan, the speed started increasing due to the gravity of the moon. If you are leaving as it is, the velocity will be the further build up and Chandrayaan 2 will escape from the Earth. So in order to ensure the Chandrayaan 2 go around the moon, that is the exact the purpose of the lunar orbit insertion maneuver. In order to reduce that the velocity of the Chandrayaan 2 from 2.4 km per second to 2.1 km per second, the lunar orbit insertion maneuver was carried out today. In this process, the Chandrayaan 2 is going around the moon with a elliptical orbit of 114 km by 18,000 km. If the lunar orbit insertion maneuver is not proper, then also the orbit of the Chandrayaan 2 will be improper, and we may not get back the Chandrayaan 2. That is the importance of the lunar orbit insertion maneuver. Now come back. After now achieving that the important maneuver, the lunar orbit insertion maneuver, what next? We are going to have the 4 more lunar burn. We are going to have the next one will be tomorrow by around 1 o'clock. Then we have 3 more maneuvers. That is 28th and 30th and the 1st September. By this process, the orbit of the Chandrayaan 2 will be reduced from 18,000 kilometer to something like 100 kilometer by 100 kilometer circular orbit around the moon by 1st September. Then the major event, next major event is happening on 2nd September, wherein the lander will be separated from the orbiter. Till now, the entire operations are carried out by the propulsion systems from the orbiter. And from September 2nd onwards, the entire attention will be towards lander. That is, lander will be separated from the orbiter. It is like the bridegroom is separated from the parents' house. Now it will be entering into the bride's house, this one. That way it is separated. And then onwards, the operation will be on the lander. What really happening is, on 3rd, we would be having a small maneuver, retro deorbit maneuver for about 3 seconds to ensure whether the systems in the lander are normal. After confirming the normalcy of the system, then 4th September, we will be doing the real deorbit maneuver at lander for about 6.5 seconds. In that maneuver, the lander will be put in an orbit of 35 km perigee and about 97 km apolur, not perigee, perilune, 35 km perilune and 97 km apolur. That way the lander will be there on 4th. Next 3 days, we'll be checking the various parameters of the lander to ensure that everything is on right, and to check and verify once again the system perfectly all right. Once we are confirming the system health is all right, on 7th early morning, 1:40, the powered descent starts. And next 15 minutes at 1:55, the lander will be landing at a site 71 degrees south of equator, moon's equator, with a 22.8 degree east. It is between two craters called Mancinus C and Simplibes N. Between these craters, the thing will be landing. After landing on the lunar surface, 2 hours later, the ramp in the lander will come down and touch the ground. And then 3 hours 10 minutes later, the solar panel of the rover will be deployed. And 3 hours 50 minutes, the lander will start move from the rover will start from the lander. And at 4 hours, the lander will be touching on the moon surface. This is our plan, and I'm sure that the precision with which our LOI and the TLI we have carried out, I'm sure that we'll be able to achieve the successful landing on moon on 7th by 1:55. That is our the plan, and I'm for this purpose that I want all your support for encouraging us and giving more and more good words, so that we'll have more energy for that. That's what I want. I would like to convey to all of you. This one.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for capturing the complexity in essence of the mission. And now it is open to the interaction with Chairman. Kindly first tell your name and the media house you represent. Then you ask the question. While he is answering that, question. Don't interrupt. Please wait for some time. Yes, Nagar.
This is from India today. Will the Prime Minister be on the spot on 155 AM on September 7 to witness the landing?
That we sent the invitation to Prime Minister.
Has he confirmed, sir?
No, that Prime Minister. The Prime Minister thinks it will be coming only last minute, the program.
However, you've been able to wake up that time. How is it that you're still able to reach the destination on 6 to 7 September as earlier planned?
No, that is basically that is not the making of the time. It is the trajectory. We wanted to reach the moon. We are planning such that we are not losing any time. This one. I mean, we are not missed the moon. That is the way we got. It is the apogee, the burn, that is a high earth burns, as well as the translunar injection times were planned. So at the same time, along with that our lunar bound burns are also planned. All these the main burns are planned such that it is maintained. There is the 7th September. Yes, we are 7th September is specifically. This is the starting of the day of the moon. So that we do not miss this one.
How critical is the requirement of the lander to land in a flat surface, and what is the test being conducted by the lander before landing?
Now this the criticality of the landing will come. There will be many things, like suppose this lander is landing on a inclined surface, then what will happen is it will get toppled. So this the slope of the landing surface should be less than 12 degree. If it's more than 12 degree, the whole thing will topple. And suppose the one leg is the sitting on a boulder, then also that toppling will be there. So this the region where we have selected, it is having that slopey region less than 12 degrees, so that ensure that it is
viewers, you were listening to Dr. K. Sivan, chairman of ISRO, giving us the entire timeline. Of course, the big day ahead is 7th of September, 1:55 p.m. is when the Chandrayaan 2's lander will disengage and make a soft landing at the South Pole of the lunar surface. With that, we will, of course, keep a close track of the developments there. A very exhaustive, detailed program being mentioned by the ISRO chairman. Remember, India's moon mission has reached a step closer to history as Chandrayaan 2 has entered the lunar orbit at 9 a.m. this morning.